And we want them to be the best, but we need the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best help is when we say, وَاصْلِحْ لِي فِي ذُرِّيَّتِي. Because regardless of what we do, they can stray and they could do things wrong. And it's very important that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us straighten our children and keep them on the right path. إِنِّي تُبْتُ إِلَيْكُمْ وَإِنِّي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgive us, we ask for a tawbah, and we acknowledge that we are the Muslims. So this dua, inshallah, we should learn because it's a fulfilling dua that we are thankful, and we ask Allah that we do the right thing and to help us with our children and to accept our tawbah, inshallah. And then if we look at the last dua Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam, he said, قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَهَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي. Prophet Sulaiman, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiving. And it's very important when we do dua, we start by asking for forgiving. Because anything bad that could have happened to us had happened because we did a mistake. So first thing, we ask to Allah to forgive us. And then we ask for what we want. And subhanAllah, if we look at what Prophet Sulaiman wanted, مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي. He wanted a kingdom and power nobody else would have. And it shows nothing wrong. He's asking for a dunya to help him towards an akhirah. So he asked for a kingdom and a power that nobody else could have. And we know the incident where Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was praying in al-Masjid. And he was delayed in the prayer. So the Sahaba asked him, why were you late, Ya Rasulullah? He said, there was a genie passing in front of me and I caught him. And I almost tied him up for the children of Al-Madinah to play with him. And then I remembered dua Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam, رَبَّ اجْعَلْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي. And this is one of the things for the kingdom and the power that Sulaiman has is the control of the genies. So he said, if it wasn't for my respect for the dua of Prophet Sulaiman, I would have tied him up for the children of Al-Madinah to play with. Subhanallah. So he's respecting the dua of Prophet Sulaiman. And Prophet Sulaiman's dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right away, فَسَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الرِّيحَ تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the wind. He controls the wind. وَالشَّيَاطِينَ and the jinn. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this part of his dua. We have to learn how to pray. And we read from the Quran and learn because these are the best thing. Because sometimes we think we ask for the right thing while we are asking for the wrong thing. And the best dua from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allahumma as'alka al-khayr kullu ma a'lamu wa ma la'alamu. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, Ya Allah, I ask you all the good things, what I know and what I don't know. وَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنِ الشَّرِّ كُلُّ مَا أَعْلَمُ وَمَا لَا أَعْلَمُ. And I seek refuge from you from all the bad things, what I know and I don't know. Subhanallah, simple dua is asking for all the good things, what he knows and what we don't know. Because there could be a lot of good things we do not know. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. You might dislike something and it's good for you. So here inshallah we have to learn the dua. And we have to learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer as it says in the Quran, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ اِدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it a clear statement. Ask and I will answer. And as we said, it could not be conditional because it's not fair that somebody listening to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ask and I will answer you. And then he goes to a scholar and he says, no, let me tell you the fine print. Let me tell you what you should have done and let me tell you 10 conditions and. But he says, I heard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, ask and I will answer you. Subhanallah. Which one do we believe, all the 10 conditions or 15 things or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And I always give the example. If me as a manager tell my staff, work hard and I'll give you a reward and a bonus, and then when they come to me, I say, sorry, you didn't read the right print. Read the whole book and read the other book and then come to me and say, what would they say about Ashraf? They'll say he's a crook. How could he tell us this thing and after we worked hard, tell me read all this book and read the other explanation and then come and ask me. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. I am close and I answer the prayers. We have to believe in this. He is with us all the time and he answers us. Yes, sometimes it takes some time, but it will be answered, inshallah. اللهم اهدنا يا مولانا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت واعطنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم بارك لنا فيما أعطيت اللهم انك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم عنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في جمعنا هذا ذنبا الا غفرته، ولا مريضا الا شفيته، ولا هما الا فرجته، ولا دينا الا قضيته، ولا حاجه لنا في هذه الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح الا قضيتها يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الاحياء منهم والاموات. اللهم اغفر لنا ولاخواننا الذين سبقونا بالايمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين امنوا. ربنا انك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قره اعين، واجعلنا للمتقين اماما. عباد الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم، واقم الصلاه.